SBS here and welcome back to my channel. So for today's lesson, I'm going to share to you the mathematics lesson, and this is a continuation of our lesson yesterday. It's the quotient rule for exponents. So handa na po ba kayo? So kung handa na ka po kayo, please keep watching. Okay guys, so for today's lesson, pag-aaralan po natin ang quotient rule for exponents. So, di po ba, as what I've mentioned just now, that there's a lot of law of exponents. But yesterday, I have discussed about the product rule. So, as a review, when we're talking about the product rule, we are going to use the product rule if they have the same base. When we're talking about the quotient rule for exponents, you will be using this quotient rule for exponents with the same base. So what I have here, x raised to m and x raised to n. The base there, guys, is x and x. So you can also, you can only use the quotient rule if the two numbers have the same base. And the m and n here are what we call the exponent. So, we're x, m minus n. When we are talking about the quotient rule, you are going to subtract the exponent. See to it that x is not equal to 0. Why? Because if the value of your x and x here is equal to 0, then you can do, you cannot do the quotient rule. You cannot apply the rule in this law of exponent. And see to it that m is greater than n. Why? Because you have to subtract the exponent. If the value of your m is greater than n, then madali lang po mag-subtract. Pero you cannot say that the value of your m is less than n because the value of that is negative. So let us apply the law 3 raised to the 5th power and 3 raised to the 2nd power. So, have you noticed, guys, that 3 and 3, pareho silang base. And if we are going to use the quotient rule, 3 and 3, so just copy the base and subtract the exponent. So, 5 minus 2, so that is equal to 3, and 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. So, 3 raised to the 3rd power. If you are going to simplify it, meaning 3 cubed, multiply 3 by itself 3 times. So, you can say or 3 times 3 times 3. So, if you will multiply 3 times 3 will give you 9. 9 times 3 will give you 27. So, this is now the simplified form of this. But how about this one? A raised to the 6th power over A. Ibig sabihin, when there is no number, the exponent is always 1. A real number, a variable, the exponent is always 1 pag wala po ditong exponent. So, AA, they have the same base, right? So, the answer is A raised to 6 minus 1, then that is equal to A raised to the 5th power. So, this is now the final answer. If you are going to use this one, kasi pare, variable na po yun, ibig sabihin, if you are going to simplify, ibig sabihin niya, limang beses, you need to multiply letter A, a variable A, 5 times by itself, then it will give you A raised to the 5th power. Did you get it, guys? So, another one, I have here an example wherein number 3, that is equal to Y raised to the 3rd power over y. Okay, now, have you noticed that the value of your m is less than the value of your y? If I'm going to ask you which is bigger, 1 or negative 3, the answer is 1. Okay, because in a number line, in a number line here, at the center here is 0, and this is the origin, all the numbers on the left side are all negative. So, negative 2, negative 3. So, this one is 1, 2, and 3. So, if I'm going to ask you which is bigger, which has a bigger value, positive 1 and negative 3. So if you have come up with this value, guys, y raised to negative 3 over y, then you can do also the operation, but it will take you a lot of time kasi isi-simplify mo po yon. So magiging ganyan po, y raised to negative 3, right? Okay, minus positive 1. When you are subtracting, this is a positive 1, right? So when you are subtracting, see to it that you are going to sign the change the sign of the second value, right? So magiging ganyan po yon. So y negative 3 tapos magiging negative 1. Negative 3 minus 1. So they have the same sign, right? If you are going to apply the rule in adding integers, pag pareho silang value, you are going to add, right? So magiging y raised to the negative 4. But the value of your exponent is negative. In order that you will change that to positive, then magiging ganyan na po yun, guys. So y, di ba ang y mo inasa numerator, nasa taas. So if you will change your exponent as a positive, ililipat mo po siya sa baba. So therefore, magiging 1 over y raised to the 4th power. So this is now the value. Because if the exponent is negative, see to it that you have to change that to positive. If the value is on the upper, ganun na po yung negative exponent din eh. Negative exponent po yung ginagamit. It's also the rule, the law of exponent. So ito po ha, so 3 raised to the 5th power, a raised to the 6th, and then this one. So we're done already with the product rule, and then the quotient rule, and then tomorrow another law of exponent. So I hope guys that you learned something today, and have a great day everyone. Bye-bye.